Hey there, I'm Nate Tennant with Gold Seal, and I want to address an instrument question that seems to come up all the time. What are the requirements for a procedure turn, and when do you have to fly them? Published procedure turns were designed to help pilots navigate an instrument approach in the safest and most efficient way possible. Often that means a smooth and safe course reversal or the ability to descend in IMC within the published maneuvering side of the approach. If we look at an approach chart like this one, we can look at the final approach course and see this barb sticking out. This signifies that a procedure turn is needed to reverse course. Another course reversal method would be a holding pattern depicted like this. The only difference with the holding pattern and the published procedure turn is the ability to complete more than one lap should you need to lose more altitude. So when are you required to execute these procedure turns? That seems to be the biggest question among pilots. There are three situations listed in the Aeronautical Information Manual where a procedure turn should not be performed. 1, when you're being radar vectored. 2, when you're on a timed approach from a holding fix. 3, when the chart specifies NOPT. But there's a fourth situation where a procedure turn isn't needed, and that's when ATC has specifically given you a straight-in clearance. This brings me to the most important part of this whole lesson, and that's communication. Let's look at an example. Let's say we're flying into Lee Gilmer Airport in Georgia. We're coming in from the west, and we've been cleared for the ILS runway 5. We've been cleared for the approach, but since they didn't explicitly say cleared straight in, and we're not being radar vectored, we're still required to fly inbound to the initial fix and fly the procedure turn. But that doesn't make much sense, right? If we're inbound on the final approach course already, then it would be counterproductive to make a more than 180-degree turn away from the airport to perform that procedure turn. So what do? We ask, are we cleared straight in? 99 times out of 100, ATC will respond with an updated clearance that includes the words cleared straight in. Communication between the pilot, that's you, and ATC is critical when it comes to executing approaches correctly. The golden rule here, and this applies to all things throughout your instrument training, is that if you don't know, ask. ATC controllers are there to help you, but it's up to you to ask. So if you don't know if you should fly the procedure turn as published or not, don't worry, just ask. Most of the time, if you're within radar coverage, ATC will give you cleared for the straight in. But if you're not under radar coverage or something else may be going on, they may ask you to fly the full procedure, in which case you should proceed to the initial approach fix, fly exactly what's published, and that includes the course reversal. So to recap, the only situations in which you do not fly the procedure turn are 1, when NOPT is written on the chart. 2, when you're on a timed approach from a holding fix. 3, when you're being radar vectored, or 4, when you've been cleared straight in from approach control. Otherwise, you fly the full procedure as is published. Thanks for watching, guys, and I hope that answered some of your questions. Good flying.